many developer. Actually, they have a knowledge, very very smart on that field. But they cannot communicate in English. Yeah, so they kind of hide under the ground.
I really like the energy that come from the people who join on the meetup and sharing what they learn together in the same topic. I really like that a lot. Having a people to join regularly and having a newcomer to join without like a brick wall is really essential for the software to run and grow in the long run.
So my name is Gatak and I am software engineer and also an organizer for PyCon Thailand, run a community Thai Ladies Bangkok.
Hey, I'm Man. I'm so software engineer as well, and I'm also a Pythonista, like Gatak said, that's in Thai Lady. I managing my old Facebook page called Khien Wu Hai Wu Gua, or it's Why Python to Scare How, which is a Facebook page to like promote the usage of Python community in the Thai language. And besides software engineering, I do a lot of flight simulator, and I actually this is the first thing I do when I like using the computer as I was a child. When I was just 10 years old, and open the flight simulator games, and that's the first thing, and I really addicted to it. And this that's like a two things that I do, like programming and flying, just switch between two for the whole life.
So I think I started coding on 15 at around that. Yeah, my dad brought me a book, a secondhand book, and I started writing a website, a news website. Yeah, that pretty static, and I have to update him every day for the news. we started meeting at our ex company.
Yeah,
and he is like a mentor for he is very smart and at that and I have to ask him about something that I cannot build on my machine, kind of setting up the local development, and I asked him.
She really shy, as she mentioned before. Mm-hmm. And I'm so curious that why she's so like so shy and so quiet, and I already see that she really needed help and she gets stuck on the problem.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, so I need to use the time machine and bring you all back to my school time. Yeah. So I start joining many competition back then, like singing contest.
Wow.
Yeah. And also many of the academic competition, like English speech and also crossword, many of them. And also I think I started organized my first tech event on around my third year of the university. And I really like the people to join the event and share what they are interested in. And also I like to connect to people because it makes me see how the world big.
I like the idea that connect to the people as well. And I kind of remember exactly when I start to think about this, like after like a few college years and reading a lot of blog posts, YouTube video, and listening to podcasts, I told myself that I think I need to start something. I need to share something back because I learned a lot. And when you learn a lot, you got so much to share, you know? And after that, I start to write a blog post, create a Facebook page, stuff like that. I even organizing the meetup as well. And I really like the energy that come from the people who join on the meetup and sharing what they learn together in the same topic. I really like that a lot.
Yeah. So I think many people around the world or around the country, even if they are not in this big city, want to help to contribute to the community, but they don't know how to start, what the expertise they have. Yeah, so I think one way to help them to join the community and show their talent is to reach out to them. Yeah, so I contact them personally and chatting around. Yeah. Talking about what you are expertise in, and what you want to talk or do you want to speak on this event is kind of suit up to you. Yeah, so yeah, give them confidence and help them to start. Yeah, it's a baby step to help contributing, yeah, to our community more and more.
I have a different approach on this as well. I learned from the maintaining the open source software that there is a thing called a low hanging fruit, good first issue, where it's a small problem or an easy problem in the software that people who is new to the software or a newbie can join and solve that problem, which is require little effort and they can celebrate really fast. And this kind of thing is important because having a people to join regularly and having a newcomer to join without a brick wall is really essential for the software to learn and grow in the long run.
So I think one thing that I keep doing this because I'll always get a passion after I have organized the event or joining the community, because I have to be a mentor for the startup contest, something like that. And I have to mentor all the teams and help them and advise them to join the contest. And I really, really enjoy that the people around, even if they are a student in the college, but they also have the passion to build the stuff that meant to the world. Yeah, so that's kind of helped me to have a passion to do things like this.
I guess one thing I have seen in the Thai norm culture is I think it's more Asian culture. It's we have to respect the people who older than you, something like that. And this kind of thing is discourage the really, really, really young people to speak up and share knowledge, because they tend to scare that they would do not well, and the older person might be challenge them and they lose confidence easily.
So for me, I think the challenge is language. Maybe because actually they have a knowledge, very, very smart on that field, but they cannot communicate in English, so they didn't try that much. I think
that unfortunately that many talented people that we have know from my life and from their lives, mm-hmm. that they're not quite good in English, and they should have been shy more to the world.
How
did you do it? I think after we learn each other a lot, and we kind of think in the in the same way, we believe in the in the non-violent communication and empathy, and we believe in the knowledge sharing, and we like to do a community stuff. I think this kind of stuff help us the relationship grow together, because we do a lot of things together. We organize the event, we sharing knowledge a lot, and we doing the community together, something like that. I guess after I working in the software industry for a few years now, I think if I go back in time, I would tell myself that I should contribute to open source sooner, because I think that the easiest way to go to the really hard problem, which is the maintaining software for the a world scale audience and world scale users, that would be benefit for the future career a lot.
If I could go back in time, I would tell myself to speak up more, because I am very shy person back then, and also care maybe too much for the people how they think about me when I was working in that environment, that I haven't speak up more. But I realized that nowadays that I have many things that I think is the right. In the tech community, we are having environment that male dominate. Yeah, for the community. So I give them that if you don't want to start in the community that very big, so why not joining the Pi Ladies community, just for women, and try to talk about what you are interested in and what the pain you are facing in the workplace, something like that. So they try to speak up for their experience and kind of icebreaking that they can talk first. Yeah, and then they show how talented they are. Yeah.
I would say that I hope a lot on the empathy part. I mean, I saw many, many blog posts, many YouTube videos, many tutorials, and people spend a lot of their time create this stuff, this content. And I saw often that there's a negative comment on this kind of stuff, and it's discouraging the people who spend their time to create the content to not doing continue doing stuff that is good and things. Yeah, I hope to see the empathy.
Yeah, actually, I kind of think the same thing as him, because in our community, what's the most important is for me is the empathy. I hope that in our community to see the normal thing that people can speak up. Yeah, you are in front of the stage and people listen to you, and people need to have like an empathy, listen carefully what actually the people in front of the stage would think. Also listen without judge. Yeah, it's kind of very important, because the people right there is take and gather all the memory that they have. Yeah, if they have and support from the people around, it will help to build a great community.
Yeah, exactly.